Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to another Modern Warfare video. Last night on Twitter, The Gaming Revolution put out a bunch of leaks in regard to Modern Warfare. If you don't know who The Gaming Revolution is, this man has been single-handedly leaking everything for Modern Warfare, and so far his track record shows he's 100% correct. So I tend to believe the stuff that he puts out there. I'm gonna link his tweets down below in the description so you guys can check him out on your own volition. But today we're going to be talking about the beta and, more importantly, information surrounding what's going to be coming throughout the first weekend and beyond. Let's just go ahead and read off these tweets one by one. Big Modern Warfare beta leaks. At the start of the PS4 beta, the level cap will be 10 and will not be increased until all three platforms are included. The perk Quick Fix was taken out of the beta, but will still be a perk within the perk 1 slot in the full game. PS4 users will be able to pre-download the beta on the 10th. Digital pre-orders for Modern Warfare on the PS4 will be able to pre-download the beta at 10 a.m. Pacific time. For non-digital pre-orders, PS4 redeem codes for the beta will be sent out on the 10th as well, right around 11 a.m. Pacific time. The 10th is tomorrow, by the way, so if you digitally pre-ordered it, hopefully this comes true, that way you can preload the beta, because rumor is right now it's 60 gigabytes in order to download the full thing. Xbox and PC will be able to pre-download on the 18th, once again 10 a.m. for digital downloads and 11 a.m. for retailers. PS4 redeem codes will start being sent out. Once Xbox and PC get access to the beta on the 19th and the 20th, the level cap will be increased to 20. Once the 21st hits, the level cap will be increased to 30. 30 will be the max level cap increase for the beta. There will be playlist updates throughout the beta. The 21st through the 23rd will be the only days where Ground War 32 versus 32 will be available. There will also be a 2x weapon XP on select days during the beta to allow players to test out more gunsmith attachments. For weapon attachments, some require a certain weapon level to equip, but for certain attachments, once you have reached the required level, there will be additional tasks to unlock, such as kill 50 enemies, and some attachments will have double unlocks. And what I think he means by that is, there are certain types of sights that you can get. So maybe the first red dot sight that you're able to get is going to require you to get to level 2, while the second one will require you to get 50 kills while using that red dot sight, and the third one might require you to get, I don't know, 20 slide kills. Just throwing ideas out there, I don't really know how it's going to work at this point. Progression from the PS4 beta will carry over to the second week of the beta. Parties will have a max count of 6 people in the beta, no larger, despite larger player count modes. Specialist streaks and specialist perks will not be available in the beta. The beta will feature 7 to 9 maps. 4 of those will be gunfight maps from the alpha, excluding one. The main maps are Hackney Yard, Cave, Runner, and Quarry. Then there's Raid, the 10v10 map, and 20v20 will not be in the beta, just 10v10 and 32 versus 32 added later. Anya Palace will not be in the beta. That's the map that I had a chance to play and the gameplay that you're looking at right now on the screen. No hardcore mode in the beta, but instead we have tactical realism, which is just like hardcore with lower health, team killing disabled, and some minor changes from standard hardcore. I was really hoping they would have hardcore in the beta based off of the interview that they did with Game Informer, but things have changed since the weeks that that has happened, so I would assume that hardcore is still going to be in the full game, but tactical realism is what you're going to have to experience if you want to have somewhat of a hardcore mode. 2 night map variants will be in the beta as well, and he goes on to say, clarification, Quarry is not the Modern Warfare 2 map, it's not 6v6, it's the 32 versus 32 map. I said this before, but it's around 60 gigabytes. So yeah, that is rounding up everything that he had to say. That's a lot of information. And the thing is, I believe it. I have no reason not to believe it. You know, the other thing is too, I've seen a lot of people saying, wow, 60 gigabytes, that's huge. Just for a beta, that's more than a lot of full-fledged games that are out right now. And really the only answer that I can give in regard to this, because I did ask a couple of the developers while I was at Infinity Ward about the size of the game, as the assets for games increase and the fidelity of games increase and as the graphical capabilities increase, obviously the download's going to get bigger. So I just imagine as we go further and further into the future, the games are just going to require more and more space. And to me, I guess it's just kind of a given. The only bad part about taking up more space is there are still a lot of people who play these games that don't have the best of internet connections, so it just makes it harder for those people to download these things within a reasonable time. I'm pretty excited for the beta because the one thing I haven't been able to experience, even while going out to the studio and experiencing this game behind closed doors, I never got to see anything above the 20 versus 20 mode. 32 versus 32 is going to be completely brand new to me, and I'm really, really excited for that. I want to see how it handles online, and more in particular, if it's just a complete clusterfuck, or if there's going to be some type of flow to how the maps work. Now, when I originally heard Quarry, I'll put him ahead a little bit. You know, I did think a little bit about Modern Warfare 2. But so far from what I've seen, I have not seen any throwback maps from any previous Call of Duty game, and I'm totally okay with that. I don't know about you guys, but we've been asking for new ever since we started seeing, remakes and stuff like that in Black Ops 4. I'm fine with new. Give me new. If you're going to do a couple of throwback maps, I get it, but new is good to me. I don't know about you guys. There was one other thing that The Gaming Revolution mentioned last night. We have multiple nukes incoming. Get in and get out. I'm assuming that this is a voice line from the multiplayer. And I'm just trying to wonder, like, multiple nukes, are you able to call in more than one at the same exact time? And if so, what the heck does that mean for the map? Is it just going to be completely blown up? I've seen that he's mentioned that there are multiple ways to earn a nuke as well. So I'm trying to figure out if there is an objective way to earn one by doing a certain amount of things objectively to get one. Or is it just based on kills, you know, going on a 25 or 30 gun streak without using your streaks in between? And then on top of that, if you call in a nuke, is the game going to completely end? Or are we actually going to have a way to end the game by calling in multiple nukes at once? So it's going to be a combined effort to try to end the game if you really wanted to do that. Another question that I have is, are the nukes going to change the way a specific map works? Is it going to fundamentally change the way the map looks? I mean, if you guys remember back to COD Ghost, you call in a KEM strike, and it would change how certain maps look. I would really like to see that happen, especially in the 32 versus 32 mode. If you drop a nuke on a quarry, it's not going to stay the same exact way. New sightlines could be created, the map could be completely different, and honestly, it opens up a lot of possibilities for changing up a way the map variants work in this game. Having a nuked out version and a standard version could be pretty damn cool when it comes to the map rotation, and it could add extra replayability to this game just on that alone. So yeah, I have a lot of questions, and the beta is only a few short days away. Rumor has it that the preload starts tomorrow, if you guys digitally downloaded the game. I'm definitely going to have a ton of videos for you all coming out when the beta comes out, because there's just so much that I want to explore, so much that I want to do, so much that I want to explain and finally show you guys from what I've been able to experience from the small playtime that I've had at that big 20 versus 20 event. But overall, it is going to be a really fun weekend, and I'm hoping all of you guys can jump in and play the open beta. No pre-order required. Once it goes open, seriously, just download it and give it a try. Don't take my word for it. I've been saying this for months now. I've said this in previous videos, but be skeptical about the shit that I say. Don't take my word for it. Don't trust my word on this. Play the open beta. Seriously, get in there, download it for free. You don't have to pre-order the game. You don't have to spend $5. You don't have to buy anything. You just log on to your little PS4, your Xbox, you download the beta, and then you play it. And I want to see what you think about it. I've had a ton of people saying that they are not going to play it because it's Call of Duty and they don't want to give it any money. Well, the good thing is, you don't have to. You don't. Just download it, give it a try. If you think it's a stinky pile of dog shit, then delete it and move on. But otherwise, I really feel like a lot of people are missing out on something different. Something completely refreshing, in my opinion. I don't know how you guys felt about after the alpha, by the way. 2v2 doesn't really express how this game feels. You know, you haven't had a chance to see that customization yet, which is why I'm really glad that the gunsmith is going to be available within this beta. There's just a lot to do, a lot to see, and from what I'm understanding, a lot to unlock, stuff to grind for. That's something we've been looking for a very long time. Anyway, guys, that's going to conclude today's video. I hope you all enjoyed it. If you did, take a moment of your time to click that like button down below. Don't forget to subscribe if you're brand new to the channel and you've never been here before. If you are new to the subscribe squad, make sure to join the notification squad by ringing the bell icon next to the subscribe button. That way YouTube will notify you every single time my videos go live, and I will catch you all on the next video. Peace.